When you ask what I enjoy most about being a psychologist, I would have to say it is helping kids who have learning disabilities, attention deficit disorder, and the host of mental health problems that kids have, helping them function more effectively in school, which is where they spend the maybe not the majority, but an awful lot of their time. There are many more kids with these problems than people realize. Research has shown that one in every four children has a mental health or learning disability. That's about five kids in every class of 25. One of my frustrations over the years has been that I can evaluate and diagnose a child in a classroom, but I don't have the time to speak with all the teachers whose classes these kids go back into. Teachers, general ed teachers, get virtually no training in understanding or managing or teaching these children. I have given presentations to teachers over the years, and they have expressed how desirous they are of somebody giving them some training on these children. Schools are so focused, though, today on grades that it just doesn't seem to happen. Despite the fact that we know that someone's emotional status is going to significantly affect their academic performance. So I decided a few years ago to write a book for teachers. The book is called Teaching Kids with Mental Health and Learning Disorders in the Regular Classroom. It's published by Free Spirit. It's written and published in a very nice format so that it's almost a manual. You don't have to read the whole book. You're a teacher, you know you don't have a lot of extra time, you don't want extra books to read. If you have a child coming in who's been diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder, you just go to the four or five pages on that disorder. Each disorder is listed in about four or five pages. The description of the behavior comes first, and then strategies, suggestions for accommodations come next. You want to know what Asperger syndrome means, you go to that section. The other nice thing is that many children are not evaluated and diagnosed. You may notice, though, in the classroom that there's something of concern about their behavior and you're not exactly sure what it means. You can go to the book, read through the various disorders, and see whether that child's behavior matches any one of these disorders. And if it comes close, you may have tentatively identified a very real problem that this student has. You're in a position, certainly not to diagnose the child, but to make a referral to people inside the school or even outside the school to assist this child in getting some kind of a diagnosis and perhaps treatment for their problem. So I'd have to say that at this point, 3 years later, I'm still satisfied with what I do in the office and feeling very good about the fact that there is a resource out there for teachers if they want to avail themselves of this, because I don't suspect that they're going to get any more training in this in the near future than they have in the past to help them deal more effectively with these kids.